Bonjour!
Bonjour!
No.
Time for bladder check.
Check.
So, it's a show?
It's a lifestyle. It's a religion.
My emotions! My emotions!
I'm still French.
Ouais, c'est pas faux.
I'm a woman, Mary. I can be as contrary as I choose.
Non, moi je crois qu'il faut que vous arrêtiez d'essayer de dire des trucs.
Hello, hi, I'm Laura. Alice in Borderland Season 1 Episode 3. I already watched the two first episodes of this Season 1. If you want to see my reaction videos about that, I'm gonna put the link into the eye. And yes, I just cracked, no? My bones when I made that. Usually I'm cutting these parts, you know, during the editing when I'm listening that my bones are doing something like that. I'm making a lot of noise, you know, if I'm doing that. Did you hear it or not? Can you hear it? Sorry! I know that for some people it's disgusting. Okay, I'm gonna watch Alice in Borderland. Today I'm gonna watch one or two episodes. I want to watch two episodes. I hope that I'm gonna have the time for that. It's gonna depend on how long these episodes are and also how much I'm talking in intros and reviews. I'm glad to be back for Alice in Borderland to discover this show, which was out some months ago now. And I hope that you guys, you're gonna love it, you know, me reacting to it, watching it again with me, or maybe discovering it with me, because you were a lot to tell me to react to it when I react to Squid Game. And for now, I didn't post my reaction videos to the two first episodes, so I don't know if you're gonna be there or not, if you're gonna appreciate my reactions and my thoughts about it. We'll see. I don't have a lot to say in the intro because till now I don't have any theory. Like, I have theories, but none of them is satisfying me. I edited the two last episodes, and about the characters, I said what I said and I'm not gonna come back to that. You know, the three guys that are really the main characters, they made that clear by taking the entire first episode only for them. We have Shota, who is the sweet guy who had a bad experience, you know, with his mother, who is into a cult, with someone taking advantage of her and also maybe taking advantage of her money. We have also Arisu, who is a clever guy, who is not using his brain enough into the real world, like we had all of that about the fact that he was not trying to find a job and was maybe a little lazy. I'm not even sure of that, you know, why he didn't want to find a job. They never explained it. It's maybe related to his mom who died, maybe it's related to something else, we'll see. We have Karube, and yes, he's my favorite character for now, because yes, of the fact that when I see him, I see Onizuka a lot, the great teacher Onizuka, because of his hair, because of his clothes, but also because of his attitude, the fact that he knows how to fight, you know, to punch people, but his attitude also with women and stuff like that, and the little lesson of life that he gave to Arisu at the beginning of the episode 1 is making me think of Onizuka. But for himself, I love the fact that he's loyal to his friends for now. You know, the fact that he wanted to play to that game, that second game, because he thought that it could be a good way to help Shota, like, to be like that with his friends, so protective and all. I truly appreciate that. After that, we have the two girls. We have, I'm sorry for the names, I have trouble to remember all of the names. Shibuki. It's Shibuki, right? The girl, you know, was manipulating Shota so much during the last episode. I mean, during the episode and after the episode, I was like, she's manipulating him with sex, she wants to have stuff from him, maybe she wants him to be a good ally for the next game, maybe she wants stuff like that. When I edited the episode, it was so obvious, in fact, that she was manipulating him that much. She insisted on the fact that his friends, maybe they're gonna betray him during the next game, and her and him, Shota, they have so many stuff in common, they should be allies, they are the only ones that they can trust, you know. She manipulated him a lot, and it's bothering me because We don't know a lot about the girl, if not the fact that she was sleeping with her boss and that she didn't like that. So we don't know why she was doing it. But I really don't appreciate the fact that she's doing such a bad thing, you know, by manipulating Shota, because she saw that he was maybe the weakest one into the group. Because Shota, he doesn't deserve that. And because her, she could have been really an interesting character. Not doing that, you know, not doing something so bad, I would want to discover more about her. And by doing that, I'm not sure that I want now to discover something else about her. We'll see. And we have Yuzua! I was right! We have Yuzua, the girl who knows how to climb like that, who made that promise, you know, to her father to succeed, to stay alive. So we have these characters and we have this game, this big game, in which they are playing little games to stay alive, to gain days of visa, you know. If they are not succeeding, they are killed by lasers coming from the sky. Where are they? Into a parallel world? Into a game? How all of these people disappeared? Did they disappear? Did you disappear? How can it be? Why you were chosen, you, to play to that game? I still don't know why, especially you. I have so many questions. All of this thing, you know, about the fireworks, about the fact that all of the electric stuff, they are not working anymore. But at the same time, he was charging, you know, the white guy, I don't know how to name him, the one into the last game who was having white hair. This one, he was charging his stuff, like electricity is still working. You can still charge your stuff. He seemed to know a lot, that guy. A lot of them know already a lot, because some of them are there since a long time. They played to a lot of different games. But how Shibuki described when she came into the game, it seems that they went into the game at the same time. Or maybe not, because when it happened for her, we didn't have the fireworks or something like that. Are they entering into the game at the same time or not? I hope that it's not at the same time, because if they enter into the game at the same time, it would be really bad, because it would mean that the time is not passing at the same rhythm for all of them, which is gonna complicate everything, you know, for my theories about that world, that big game. But at the same time, people, you know, the entire world is not disappearing for each one of them, you know, at a different moment. So I don't know. See, I have so many questions and I have really no theories. Each time that I'm beginning a theory, I'm like, no, that's not working. And who is doing all of that? Making people disappear like that, or you disappearing like that, creating that false world, that big game, that thing? Why that person chose you? I don't know. And I don't think that they're gonna know that, you know, going to that beach to have the answer. How it was said, you know, that thing about the answer is at the beach. I think that the beach, it's a place, you know, like a bar, like an hotel, a restaurant, something like that. A place to meet. It's not a real beach. People, a group of people that are allies for the games, and they're gonna meet at that place. And that guy who just died, you know, he was a part of that organization, and that's why they had all of them, you know, the radios. And they said something like, we have the answer into our hands now. So I think that they managed to capture someone who is involved into the game. Not the mastermind, but maybe one of his soldiers, you know, I don't know. But at the same time, you know, during the last game, the horse guys, it was players. Maybe you just captured another player who knows stuff, more stuff than you. I don't know. I'm gonna stop right there with this intro. I'm gonna watch this episode. Like always, if you want, you have my Patreon on which you can have the episodes earlier. I think that on Patreon they have 2 episodes of Advance, it's a lot. And with an extended or a full reaction part, for now I put 2 extended reaction parts and it was really longer, it was like 6 minutes longer, I think. If you want to check that, go on my Patreon. It's the best way to support me. Right now on YouTube, it's a little rough, you know, for me because I'm a little reactor, so YouTube is not really considering me. But if you can't join me on Patreon and you want to help me right now on YouTube, you can like, subscribe, comment, share also. It's helping me. Let's go for this episode 3! Tudum! No! The game killed her. You're discovering that about yourself? No, stay! You can be a good ally. You've stayed. I thought that you already left you. I'm suspecting you a little. The fact that you didn't help that much during the last episode and you knew already about the room and all. I saw that during the editing. The town! The city, the... with the main road? Maybe it's the area of the game, you know? But what about out of this area? It's not Shibuki, or? Ah, sorry, Shibuki, okay. I'm gonna name you Shibuki. Because you fought so hard to have this place. This is right. Karube! You need a medic also for him now. No. It's not a beach, it's a place, it's a restaurant, it's something like that. You're gonna have to play the 12 You want answers? No, no, she's not there! You scared me! She's gonna try to manipulate him now? See, the picture is better! I was talking about it for the episode 1, like, I had the impression that they were making good stuff, but they could do better. That's better. They are playing with the pictures more with the camera. Like everyone, no? Are you gonna explain what happened? I think that it was a game, an art game, you know? She manipulated people or something like that. She killed them, she had to choose between her and all of them. And what? You bought it? You were really serious about her? I thought that it was just... I thought that he was just having fun with her, but he was serious. Oh, Karube. Now I really hope that they did not disappear for good. Go for it now. You're going to the same place. Always trust him.
悪いだよ。俺としぶきさんは後がないんだぞ。そのこの。
He has the right to. I should know that place. Like I said, I'm sure that for Japanese people, you know, it's so weird and so fun also to see all of these places empty. I don't know this place. I'm sorry. So now it's a portal. How many players? They don't hesitate. It's a death game, you know? And they are going to be there for Shota. Oh no, 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 you're not gonna kill someone, I think. It's like virtual reality, you know, cask thing. Botanical Garden? It's a circus music, you know. Are you gonna have to kill animals? Oh no! No, it's like the other. Ah, the other game, like you're the horse guys? Please, you're not gonna have to kill each other, please. Game of art? No, she manipulated Shota. It would mean that only one of them would win. No? Can we cheat? Can we find a solution? Can we? The one who can't run? It's not by killing each other, you just have to watch each other. It's a wolf. Yes, who needs to hide? But still, it's not helping us. It still means that only one of you is gonna survive. Like, if you will kill her, it's not gonna help the two others, you know, of you, like... Or if you are creating, you know, a circle, like, I'm looking at you, you're looking at me, I'm looking at you, like, you're hacking the game. The mask? No? I'm like, shut up! I'm trying to find a solution. I think that it's like always, by playing together you can win and survive. Shota, you're really me. He can't die. None of these three. The girl, I'm sorry, but how manipulative she was with Shota. Don't be stupid. At least, no?
Yeah.
adobe. Don't do that. You lie down. I don't want to see that side of you, Kathy. You're hearing that, you're hearing what everyone is doing to everyone. Okay, if I have to choose between the two of you, Kalube, you survive.